Hey everyone who's funneling in, welcome to this team sprint. Everybody's finding the emojis already. Love to see it. We always love to see where everybody is joining. So if you can put in the chat where you're from, that would be amazing. So Mo, Mallory, Rob, let's see where this very diverse group is actually dialing in from. Toronto, Minnesota. So we got 67 people in the session. Irwin, Hawaii. What time is it? Rolling, got me cracking up. Alright everyone, so we've got a good chunk of people in here, so why don't we go ahead and kick this off. Welcome everyone. I think if you're doing your first team sprint, if you can go to the emojis, use some sunglass emojis. We'd love to see who's doing their second emoji, who's doing their first. I think we have a ton of first timers here in this experience. Mo, Mallory, and Gaurav are here to support you. They're the kings of the castle of these experiences. They're the one that drive these, and they're all veterans. So this is going to be a really fun one for everybody. While we're jumping into this, I want to get everybody oriented with what the agenda is going to look like for this kickoff. So we're going to do quick coach introductions, introduce Mo, Mallory, Gaurav, who you'll see a lot of for the next 3 weeks. We'll talk about how the sprint is organized, what some of the goals are for the team sprint, and then how these coach working sessions will work. Lastly, everyone has been put in your team channels. We're going to give you some tips on how to work with teams, and then we'll leave some time for questions. If at any point in time you do have a question, there's two ways to go through this. First, and probably the best, is actually put it in the Q&A section in AirMeet, which is in the top kind of right section. If you want to get oriented with that, it's a great way for us to be able to answer questions once we get to that section. And then lastly, we hope to leave a little bit of time so you can all meet with your groups if you haven't already, talk about how you want to approach this actual team sprint and get you on your way and kick everything off. All right. So with that, I want to introduce you to all of your amazing coaches who are going to be guiding you through this 3 weeks. So Mallory, do you want to go ahead and introduce yourself to all of our amazing learners?
Sure. Hey, everyone. I'm Mallory Donahue. I am an associate consultant at Slalom Consulting on their digital engagement team. And so my bread and butter for the last year has been Einstein Bots and Service Cloud. So that's been really exciting. I am bringing to you a little bit of the perspective of a career shifter, much more of a newcomer than our other two coaches on this sprint who are very, very experienced veterans. I love getting to work with them because I always learn something from them during the sprints, and then also I learn something from the students. So I will be hosting quite a few of the sessions, then also acting as your user interview subject. And yeah, I can't wait to get started with you all. I can pass it over to Gaurav.
Awesome. Thanks, Mallory. Gaurav.
Hi, everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on wherever you're joining from. And welcome to this sprint. My name is Gaurav Khetrapal. I live in Jaipur in India. And this, I think, is my third sprint as a coach. And I've also done a few skills challenges. And I think the fact that you're here, it's a fantastic program. Like I've had seen so many success stories from the previous sprints and this is a bigger sprint. So I'm looking forward to some amazing stories from this group as well. I've been in the Salesforce ecosystem since a long time. 2007 was when I started. So 15 years, or as my wife calls it, been married to Salesforce since last 15 years and still going strong. Yeah, I love evangelizing Salesforce. I've been a Trailhead Academy instructor in the past. I've taught Salesforce for customers and partners, and really looking forward to this sprint. Yeah, thank you.
Awesome. Love it. And a lot of folks coming out after this will be doing the business analyst certification. Gaurav, am I right? You actually helped create that certification with Salesforce?
Not that one, but a few others.
Wrong one. Shoot, I got it wrong. But Gaurav has created a lot of those, which is, it was the Salesforce Associate one, right? That was the one that you just recently created?
Yeah,
Okay,
and you
cool.
can ask me
Awesome.
any questions. You can ask me any questions except the exam questions.
No cheating. Love it. Not that one. Perfect. Gaurav, awesome. Who have you been married to longer, Salesforce or the wife? Good times. All right, Mo, we'll kick it over to you.
Hey, thanks, Jeff. Thanks, Gaurav. So, yes, good afternoon, good evening, good morning, wherever you are in the world. My name is Mo Jassett. I'm based in the United Kingdom, in the middle of the country, in a little city called Leicester. I've been in the ecosystem, Salesforce ecosystem, for probably about 12 plus years and doing CRM in some form or another for over 20 years. I've currently worked with a company, a large global systems integrator called Cognizant, that are based in the US and have a global footprint. And I look after their relationship with Salesforce on a full-time basis globally. As I've held a number of roles over those 12 years within the ecosystem, from delivering some sort of fairly complex global projects to managing some very small projects, because I've worked for a variety of different size of partners that implement Salesforce. So, hopefully can share a lot of my experiences with you, and hopefully you guys can avoid some of the bruises that I've had over the years. But equally, I'm thrilled to have all of you on this call and to be able to learn from you. And I've done a like Gaurav and Mallory, done a few of these sprints over the last 6 months with Jeff on Clicked. And every single one has been very, very different from an experience perspective for me as a coach. And I've got a lot out of it, and hopefully the learners equally have got a lot out of it. But we learn a lot by seeing the work that you develop over the coming weeks in what is a very focused and concentrated time period. You don't have the luxury of a 6 or sort of 8 month project life cycle. You're literally going to be doing this in a number of days and weeks. And it's amazing the sort of the quality of what we see coming out from the teams. So I'm really looking forward to seeing that and being able to hopefully give you some insights and tips and hints and coaching around that. But also, as the coaches have mentioned, to learn from you as well, because there's a lot of stuff that we pick up as well from these presentations. So have some great fun. We're all looking forward to working with you over the coming weeks, and hopefully you'll see me on a couple of sessions. Back to you, Jeff.
Awesome. Love it. And Gaurav's got a great little quote here. You'll be building the plane as you fly it. Get your seatbelt on. Gonna snap that one, steal it, use it on everything. That is exactly what everyone is about to go through. And of course, the coaches are the stars. I would love for everybody to give a round of applause. Mo, Mallory, Gaurav, taking some time out of their day to be able to guide you on this journey. They're the ones that you're gonna be teaching you throughout this as they share their expert feedback and lots of different experiences through this. So thank you, Mo, Mallory, Grob. We'll kick to you here in a little bit. So here's a quick overview of how this is going to work. For do we actually have some repeat? If anybody has actually repeated some experiences, maybe do the thumbs up just so I can help orient it. If we've got a couple of people who have done the team sprints before. If you haven't, great. So we've got a few people. This is how this experience will work. It's part role-playing game. So we're going to share the scenario with you in a moment. And what we want you to do is be able to put yourself and immerse yourselves into the shoes, and you'll be contributing to the scenario as it goes along. It's also part hackathon. As Gaurav and Mo have kind of mentioned, this is going to be very quick. You're going to be working with teams. It's going to be a challenge. It's not expected to have these perfect deliverables, but going through this high-pressure environment to create some of these deliverables that will help you learn. Going to that, this is part learning session. Each of these working sessions will be a chance to learn from our coaches. Everyone, including the coaches, get to learn through these opportunities. Every time I get to go through this, I learn something new as well, which is absolutely amazing and part of the Clicked experience. And this, of course, is part job prep. You'll have the chance to kind of pick and choose what you want to focus on and target your efforts in front of not delayed staff. Sorry, this is copy paste in front of these particular coaches as they share their experiences with you. All right. So goals, what are some of the objectives of this learning experience? We want you to understand a few key components of a Salesforce consulting project, apply abstract knowledge as you try your hand on some of these realistic documents. I think Mo, Gaurav, Mallory can all probably shake your head. What they're gonna be going through would be something that they would do in the day and the knife of a Salesforce professional. So these are real tasks that you'll be working on. And a couple of other things is you'll be able to build some connections, right? We put you in teams. We'll talk about teams here in a little bit. You'll be put in teams to work on together to be able to achieve all of these objectives. And we hope that you can build some connections with some aspiring Salesforce professionals. All right, what are not objectives? We do not care if you create perfect deliverables that a real company will put into place. That is not an objective for this. We want everybody to think of this as a learning experience and make sure that you're focusing on the learning aspect of this experience. And of course, you will not be out competing other groups to determine who did the best job. That is not a goal that we want anybody to be able to. At the end of this, everyone will learn something in this experience. I can guarantee that. And we hope that you have some, you know, assets that you can actually share in your portfolio. And if not, that's also great. As long as you learned, that's the key objective to this and core to what we'll be doing. Cool. So you've made it to AirMeet. Congratulations. We have 74 people in the session, which is incredible. I think we've got about 83 people in the cohort. So thanks everyone for attending today. That is an amazing turnout. You'll be using Slack for both team communication, as well as I'll be posting all of our updates there. And of course, all of the learning materials are in the LMS, and you should have access to all of the scenarios and all of the learning materials as of, I believe, 9 a.m. today. 9 a.m. Pacific. If you don't, please reach out in the Slack channel. That's the best way to communicate with us. Sometimes things slip through the cracks, and we'll clean it up. We'll get it ready for you. And we're excited to keep going through and pushing you through this class. So how will the feedback sessions work? So for people who have returned this, you know how this works. For some of the newbies, what you're going to be doing is you're going to be working on these experiences and these deliverables together with your team. And in these feedback sessions, you will be sharing your work. When you share your work, your coaches here, Mo, Mallory, or Grob, whoever's attending the sessions, will then give you feedback on your work. And this is critical to the learning process. We don't want anybody to ever feel nervous about sharing incomplete work. That's actually a great time to share your work, right? Feel free to show scribble, scratch, think, talk through your thought process, and our coaches will help orient and guide you through that experience and know that each of the teams is going to be in different places throughout this experience. Some of you have said you've only got 2 to 5 hours of time a week. Some teams have 30 plus hours for all of their team members. It is going to vary. And again, we want to highlight that nobody should feel bad or, you know, if they're a little bit behind, that is not an objective. Just feel free to share your work because we'll all get to learn from those types of experiences. Cool. Awesome. So, team tips. We want everyone to have an honest conversation when you get with your teams and have your first connections around your goals, your availability. Again, going to, do you have 5 hours? Do you have full time? Do you have, you know, 7 kids, right? Make sure you're aligning on the real opportunities that you have to be able to contribute to this and what you might want to work on. And then, of course, we want, after you've aligned that, we want everybody to help each other, right? Including some of the other teams, right? If you get stuck and you and your team can't figure it out, please post in the Slack channel first. That is a great way for you to work within your cohort, within your team, so that everyone can kind of power through this. And of course, this is a 3-week experience. We put you in teams with complete strangers, but no, this is not an engagement ring, right? Inevitably, there's going to be some tough interactions. Know that that's part of the clicked experience. A big piece of being a working professional is working through conflict, working through team dynamics, and being able to power through in some of these situations. And I'll kick it off to some of our coaches to give a little bit of feedback on that as well here in a little bit. Cool. So last but not least, community guidelines, what it means to be a good community member and a valuable part of your team. So this is how we want you to show up. So please, please, please be considerate to your team and others. That includes the coaches. If you're going to be inconsiderate to anybody, please make it me. I will be your first line of defense if you do get stuck, but please be, you know, considerate of everybody else. As we mentioned, we want everybody to align your goals. It's really critical. And core to clicked, Gaurav, Mallory, Mo, myself have all mentioned this. We all get to learn from each other, right? Whether it's complete work or incomplete work, please share your work. These are the opportunities where you're all going to move everybody along to propel everyone's growth. And Mo had mentioned this as well, as we really want everybody to have fun, right? This is a light experience, right? We're all going to have a lot of fun through this. We want everybody to laugh, giggle, enjoy some of the music. This is core to making sure that everybody at the end of this, you both learn, but have had a good time as well. And then get feedback from your learning community first before you go to your coaches. So your coaches will be available in the feedback sessions for sure. And that should be where you expect it. Outside of that, do not really expect them to hop into Slack. But you may see Mallory jump in. You may see Gaurav jump in. You may see Mo jump in. But please, please, please don't expect it. Go to your cohort first. Go to us second. And then last but not least, if we do good stuff, we'll try to probe and see if one of the coaches can jump in. What we just highlighted, what not to do, please don't ask the coaches right away, right? Please don't be inconsiderate of others. And my favorite, highlighted in, I guess that's pink, please, 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 please don't be bossy. All right. So with that, we want to go to some coach tips. All of our coaches here have done multiple of these. They've seen some of these awesome final presentations. Mallory, I'd love to kick it to you first to maybe talk about the team dynamics and maybe some things that you can kind of share with individuals as they're jumping into this experience, high intensity learning opportunity with complete strangers across who knows where in the globe.
Yeah, so I have said this before in a sprint, so forgive me if you've heard it, but all of the challenges that you will face of working with people who are spread across the world and have different amounts of time to dedicate to this and different skill areas and skill levels, etc., those are all challenges that you will face in a Salesforce consulting or business analyst or admin environment. You will be working with people who perhaps have other jobs or other things to do, leaving you to perhaps fill in a gap you weren't anticipating. And so it makes you learn quickly, and it also makes you learn how to ask for help. So if they can't do this one thing, can they do another thing? How can we lay this all out so that everyone can take on what they can take on? And so just know that what you're experiencing isn't wrong, and it's okay to lean into that uncertainty and that sort of uncomfortable space. A-okay, we've got to do it every day. I think the other coaches will agree with me there. So just don't be surprised when it gets to be a little challenging, even outside just the Salesforce parts of it. Okay, so that's my tip.
Awesome, love it. And Mo, you want to go next? Any tips that you've got for the learners, maybe as they're going through this?
Yeah, I think absolutely everything that Mallory's sort of has just articulated, I totally agree with as well. And what I would sort of build on that is, you know, this is a great opportunity for those of you that have never presented, for example, right? It's the first time that you're coming online and you're going through, you know, some slides on a PowerPoint, or you're taking us through a demo that you've built. So, you know, I would encourage you to come forward and make it your first time, if it is the first time, to do that presentation, because it's a safe environment. You know, we're not here to judge anyone. We're here to give you some feedback and give you, above all else, the confidence to say, actually, you know what, this is the right thing for you to do. You know, you're on the right track, and just, you know, improve from where you are today. So use this as a great vehicle for boosting your confidence for those of you that are not, you know, by nature very confident of presenting to a large audience or presenting to others. The second tip that I'll give is what I've often seen on other sprints is that when you are presenting your work, treat us as the coaches as your clients. So always remember that in the back of your head, that, you know, you need to get into the role. So you are the business analyst, and Mo, Gaurav, and Mallory is the end client. So don't present to us as coaches, present us to as clients, and then we'll give you the feedback as coaches on how to do the, and how you can improve and what's gone well. So getting character, that's quite important when you're doing your presentations. And the last tip I'll give you is that this is more a marathon than a sprint. So this is your journey into Salesforce for some of you. We're not expecting you to be the finished product. We're not expecting to see finished presentations. A lot of the things that you may want to put in your presentations may be gaps that you've assumed, which is perfectly fine, because the brief, for those of you that have seen the brief around the American Red Cross, it doesn't go into a high level of detail. Generally on projects, you'll have lots of detail and you have lots of time to get to the detail. So deliberately, you know, Jeff and the team have given you a very open brief. But like I said, you know, if you don't have the answer, make it up. Doesn't matter. And we'll take that as part of your presentation. So don't get too hung up on, you know, I haven't got all the information. Just go for it. Put something together. Get it ready to a point where it's presentable to all three of us and have some fun with it, because we will. And we'll pick out the great stuff and also tips for improvement. And we'll probably have some laughs on the way as well. So that's my tips for the day, Jeff. I'll pass on to you and Grof. Right.
Go ahead, Grof.
Yeah, so I think Mallory and Mo covered most of it. I think a couple of things which I want to highlight is that it's a team sport. Like, you are as good as your team, and your team is as good as the contributions from everyone in that team. And we will be working on different schedules. Somebody might be having a tough day at work. So it's very, very important that you contribute your bit to your team. Otherwise, your team lags, and then eventually you lag as well. So I think that's very important. And that is something which I saw like work fantastically well in the last sprint. At least some of the teams, like, they gelled well, so well with each other that even after the sprint ended, like, they used to invite me on Slack, and we just used to have like a laugh and just chat about how things are going with each one of them. So again, this is a great opportunity for you to also build some new friendships in the Salesforce ecosystem. Some of you might be in the similar career journey, and nothing like having a sounding board who can listen to you and provide feedback. We'll obviously be there, but again, it's the purpose of putting you in teams is also to kind of make a closer bonding with your teammates. And apart from that, I think, yeah, if you do it in the right spirit, and if you are having fun doing it, trust me, like, you will never realize this, that this is a piece of work. I think the 3 weeks will pass very, very quickly, and I think we'll be looking at the end of the sprint. But this is a fantastic opportunity to kind of showcase your skills, fine tune your skills. Like, in the first sprint, I remember people were so hesitant that Jeff had to call people up and point people and just force them on stage. But by the time I think we did second sprint, people were queuing up for that opportunity. So make the most out of this opportunity while you have it. And yeah, wish you all the best.
Yep, love it. And Grof, I think you teed off to the one piece of advice that I would want to get, and people who have completed these team sprints and quests, is everyone will get out of this what you put in. Right. And even if you only have 2 to 5 hours, what you can put in to contribute to your team, that is what you're going to get out. Definitely opportunities to do some of the longer form experiences for all of those who complete. Life happens, everyone. If you have to bail, it's okay. We totally get that. If you want to sit in and watch in the sessions because that's all you can do, that's also great. Just keep us posted. Keep your team posted. Always align on those goals. That's why we say it is so critical. Awesome. So we've got a couple questions in the chat that I want to be able to get to. Is one, where can we find the brief? This is also connected, so I'm going to mark this as answered because I'm going to answer this one as well. What's clicked LMS? I saw that on the screen a moment ago, but didn't quite get it. This is our learning management system. So this is the app.clicked.com. I'm going to post this in the chat here. Everyone should be able to see the scenario now. If it's not open, and if you don't have access to the content I just posted and the content that I posted in Slack, it is bookmarked. Please, please, please let us know. But all of the details for what you're going to be working on, what is the actual scenario you're going to be working on, which we'll talk to in a little bit, is all in there as well. All right. So do we have an air meet tomorrow? The answer is no. The next session will be on Wednesday with Mallory. So you'll have a day plus some time here to be able to orient with your team. And then here's another. We got lots of good questions. Hey, Jesse. So how will we know when we are to do our final presentations? This will also be in the schedule in the LMS. Final presentations will be at the end of the 3 weeks. So right now it's November 4th. This is a pretty big cohort. And there's 76 people of the 83 people that we have accepted into this. So that is an incredible show. Everybody, round of applause for showing up today. That's awesome. So we'll probably break that out into at least 2 sessions, but maybe even 3 sessions, depending on how many people make it to the end of this. Awesome. Cool, cool. And then how's the team decided? So everyone should be in your teams in Slack already. So if you are not in a team group, please message me in Slack. That's how we'll know that you're in the right spot or not in the right spot, but you have been invited, and we did send that announcement in the Slack channel today. And then actually, Indira, you had the same question. So there's in the Slack, you should have had in your team. If you don't, please ping me and we'll try to add you. Sometimes there's a disconnect with the emails that are connected to your Slacks, et cetera. So we always miss a couple and then we need you all to reach out to us. Cool. So with that, we're going to kick this off. For those of you who have done this before, you knew this was coming. For those of you who have not, the team sprint has officially started and it's time for your first assignment. And we're going to introduce the scenario and then I'll kick it over to Mallory for a couple of questions around this. So this is the scenario and this is what we're going to have you work on starting right now. So you are a Salesforce business analyst working with the American Red Cross to effectively source and distribute free emergency relief supplies when natural disasters strike. So the task, you will have the opportunity to interview Jennifer Gray, the general warehouse manager for the American Red Cross. Jennifer Gray manages procurement and distribution of emergency relief supplies. Your goal is to understand how emergency relief supplies are currently tracked and distributed at the American Red Cross and to propose Salesforce solutions to increase the effectiveness and organization of this process. During this team sprint, you will complete 5 tasks, user interviews, persona building, user stories, business process mapping, and designing a Salesforce org to meet your client's needs. The tools you'll create, you will synthesize your findings and define the client's needs in a clear and succinct manner so that your team can effectively design a solution for the American Red Cross, and you will do all of this in 3 weeks. So if it sounds daunting, don't worry. People have done this before. I want to highlight back to Mo, there's going to be gaps in this. You're only going to interview one person. So where there's gaps, you get to make it up and play the game as we go along. So the actual task is in 2 days, you are going to be interviewing Jennifer Gray. Mallory will switch her roles as Mallory Donahue, associate consultant at Slalom. She will be Jennifer Gray, the general warehouse manager for the American Red Cross. And you will develop thoughtful questions to guide a discussion with that team, not the Dreamforce team. Sorry for the typo. So what we want you to do in the next few days is brainstorm as many questions as come to mind, aiming for at least 15 to 20 questions. We want you to rank what you think are the most critical questions that you want to ask. And then we want you to finally refine those questions to have 1 to 2 that you would ask Mallory, then playing Jennifer Gray in that scenario. So you're going to think about how you want to introduce yourself when you're engaging with Mallory in their interview session. And everyone in this interview session, all of the teams will be able to come up on stage and ask questions to actually guide and start to build some of the requirements for that session. So Mallory, before we jump in any further, you've done a couple of these interview sessions. I know they're taxing. I'll be there to support and help you, or actually Supriya will. Any tips for questions for the user interview when they're going through this particular scenario?
Yeah, I have 2 tips. So one, even though you will be building a Salesforce solution, don't let that Salesforce technical jargon come into your questions at this point. That's not something we're going to be, you need to get curious about the user, about the stakeholder. And they don't know about Salesforce. So you can't ask them, oh, would leads be good for this or something like that. So even though you all have been studying hard and learning this particular solution, we're going to leave that behind. That's one of the biggest challenges that a lot of Eclipse participants face. And the second is, even though your team will only be able to ask 1 or 2 questions of Jennifer Gray, come up with more, because if other people ask the question you had, you need to be ready with a different question or a follow-up. What this sort of synthesizes is, if you are in a room with other consultants and they've asked a question already, you don't want to ask the stakeholder the question again. Or if this stakeholder has been interviewed before, hopefully your team has a way of communicating with one another and you already know that information that they've given. So, you know, for time's sake, each team is only going to get to come up and ask 1 or 2 questions, but just keep that in mind. And your follow-up questions are going to be key there. So just think of that as an asset. You get to build upon what's been asked before. So just do a really great job of listening.
Awesome. Love it. Love it. Love it. Love it. Again, highlighting to that, you'll have about 35, depending on how quick we can get everybody in, 35 minutes to interview Mallory playing Jennifer Gray. When we go through this, very important that everyone uses this time to get as much information as possible out of that session, and that will kick off everything. And no worries, Mallory's going to step out. And with that, that's a wrap for this session. Everyone, we've left a little bit of time for you to go to sit with your teams, get organized, get set, and go. And as Mo has mentioned, as Mallory has mentioned, as Gaurav has mentioned, and I have mentioned, remember, this is about having some fun as well. So with that, everybody, go to your teams. You can figure out how you want to organize. We wish you the best of luck, and we will see you in 2 days on when we're actually interviewing Jennifer Gray. All right. Take care, everybody. We'll see you soon.